Paul Sanderson was dubbed the Thunder from Down Under, and he certainly lived up to the hype. The Melbourne, Australia product came to Brandon in 2007 and made an instant impact as a powerhouse outside hitter. He led Canada West in kills while being named a first-team conference All-Star. Sanderson was also chosen as a second-team All-Canadian, becoming the first BU men's volleyball player to ever receive the accolade.
Paul's just a natural athlete, really, and he's a competitor. He's smart, and he just really likes to win. I think overall that his work ethic is just so strong. Like practicing and in the gym, it just really set him aside from everybody else.
Sanderson's success continued in 2008-2009 as he guided the Bobcats to their first ever appearance at the National Championship Tournament while helping them win their first ever bronze medal. He was named the National Tournament All-Star, a first-team All-Canadian, and a first-team Conference All-Star. In 2009-2010, Sanderson's legacy continued to grow after having one of the most decorated seasons in program history. He was named U Sports Player of the Year, a first-team All-Canadian, Canada West MVP, and a first-team Conference All-Star.
I don't ever remember him taking a point off. He'd serve missiles from the back row, and the ball came to him in the front row. He would just terminate it, blow up guys on the chest, do whatever he had to do. But yeah, I just had that fire inside.
The Australian superstar returned the following season to play out the final year of his career. He was selected as a first-team Canada West All-Star and a first-team All-Canadian. Sanderson also helped the Bobcats reach a new milestone as they finished runner-up for the national championship. Sanderson was named the tournament all-star for guiding the Bobcats to a silver medal finish.
He was setting records on how many kills a game, you know, match highs and all that stuff, but Paul never brought that to anyone's attention. That was huge for me. He loved having the ball, and he wanted the ball when it mattered, but he would never bring attention to him in terms of his stat lines, and I think that makes him even better and more deserving of the Wall of Fame, in my opinion, because he wasn't someone who was out there seeking stats. He was out there just seeking to be with the boys and win, and you know, just be a good human on the court.
Sanderson's career came to a close in 2011, but his name still remains at the top of the Canada West record books. He's the conference's all-time leader in kills per set, points per set, and service aces. His amazing volleyball story includes triumph over adversity. In 2014, he overcame a cancer scare to secure a spot on the Australian national team. Just 6 months after being diagnosed, Sanderson and the Aussies were competing in the FIBA World League.
He loved the game of volleyball. He wanted to keep playing. He knew he had it in him to play at the national team level, at the pro level. So I think that just kept him going through all that. You know, I know he had a lot of support from friends and family and teammates pushing him through that time. And, you know, I wasn't surprised to see him get through that and bounce back and be where he is now.
Sanderson has also traveled the world playing professionally in 6 different countries while winning multiple league championships. The Brandon University Sports Wall of Fame is proud to induct Paul Sanderson.